प्रज्वल गायकवाड, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग, ASSMSS इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी, पुणे. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट यू अ टॉपिक ऑफ वेब सिक्योरिटी, अंडर विच वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी सिक्योर सॉकेट लेयर प्रोटोकॉल. सो व्हेन वी से एनीथिंग अबाउट वेब सिक्योरिटी, नाउअडेज वी यूज वेब फॉर बिजनेसेस, गवर्नमेंट, इंडिविजुअल्स, बट इंटरनेट एंड वेब आर वल्नरेबल. वेब सिक्योरिटी हैव अ वैरायटी ऑफ और वेब इज हैविंग वैरायटी ऑफ थ्रेट्स, दैट इज इंटीग्रिटी, कॉन्फिडेंशियलिटी, डिनाइल ऑफ सर्विस, ऑथेंटिकेशन. सो यू कैन से दैट कॉन्फिडेंशियलिटी इज द डेटा शुड बी केप्ट कॉन्फिडेंशियल, इंटीग्रिटी इज द डेटा दैट इज सेंड शुड बी रिसीव्ड, डिनाइल ऑफ सर्विस इज लाइक समवन इज सेंडिंग द डेटा बट डिनाइंग दैट इट इज सेंड बाय देम, एंड ऑथेंटिकेशन इज ओनली ऑथेंटिकेटेड पार्टी शुड कम्युनिकेट. So we needed additional security mechanisms for this, for you can say working on web. So for that we'll need one protocol which is called as SSL protocol. So we'll start with the architecture of it. It is having a simple architecture. It is having four parts that are major, or you can say if you look at the diagram, this is your application layer, then TCP layer, then IP layer. In between, we are using this SSL record protocol. So SSL is actually divided into four different protocols. One is SSL handshake, second is SSL change cipherspec, then SSL alert and SSL record. From these four, you can say two are most important and two are not that much important. We'll study how they work. We'll start with what SSL architecture is divided between two parts. One is connection, second is a session. So SSL connection is transient peer-to-peer communication link, and it is associated with one SSL session. That means whenever we are communicating, whenever we are using this, it is having only one connection. But under one connection, we can have different sessions. So SSL session is an association between a client and a server. It is created by a handshake protocol and define a set of cryptographic parameters. It may be shared by multiple SSL connections. So sessions can be shared between different connections. Now SSL record protocol services. So what does protocol is, it is used for message integrity and confidentiality. So it actually uses MAC with shared secret key, and it is similar to HMAC but with different padding, and it also uses for confidentiality. It is using symmetric encryption with shared secret key defined by the handshake protocol. So it uses like different protocols like AES, IDEA, RC240, DES40, DES3DES, Forteza, RC440, RC4128. So various versions are there, and the message is compressed before encryption. So here this SSL record protocol operation is given from this diagram. Whatever your application data is there, it is divided into number of fragments, and for each fragment what they are doing is you are compressing that fragment, then you are adding MAC, that is message authentication control, and then you are encrypting that, so it is secured, you can say. And afterwards you are adding the SSL record header, that means you are adding your own header after securing the application data. Now next protocol is SSL change cipherspec protocol. So one of the three SSL specific protocols which use the SSL record protocol. It is only, you can say, a single message that is given. So what it is doing, it just causes the pending state to become current. That means whenever the new data you're taking, you're just converting it to current, and hence updating the cipher suit in use. Now again, the next protocol is SSL alert protocol. It actually, whenever we are surfing the net, we are getting so many alerts from websites. So that is handled by this SSL alert protocol, it conveys SSL related alerts to the peer entity. So it actually gives us messages on either it is a warning or a fatal error. That means if you are surfing some website, it gives or alert us that it is fatal to use this website likewise. So those alerts are coming from the SSL alert protocol. So specific alert, it is fatal or warning. So fatal alerts are unexpected message. If it is having bad record MAC or decompression failure, if it is there, or handshake failure, or some illegal parameters are there during transit, then it can alert us of that. And for warning, if it is closed notified, no certificate is there for that specific application data, or bad certificate is there, or some unsupported certificate is there, or if certificate is revoked, or that means certificate related, if errors are there, it can warn us about that. And the user then decide whether to use that web page or website or not. And compressed and encrypted like all the SSL data. That means again the protocol using compression and encryption. Next is SSL handshake protocol. It allows server and client to authenticate each other, to negotiate encryption and MAC algorithms, to negotiate cryptographic keys to be used. It actually comprises a series of messages in phases. First is establish security capabilities. Second is server authentication and key exchange. Third is client authentication and key exchange. And fourth is finish. So these four protocols you can say are providing all the services that I have mentioned in the at the start of the presentation, that is confidentiality and integrity, all those four I mentioned. So it is providing that. So that is SSL protocol used for web security. Thank you.